In this video, I'm going to walk you through the setup and configuration of a self-hosted password manager called Pass. Now, the cool thing about Pass is that it allows you to store your passwords in a Git repository. You can then synchronize with a remote Git repository. Now, you may be thinking, well, do I really want my passwords to be in a Git repository? Wouldn't that mean whoever has access to the repo could see my passwords? No, because the way Pass works is it takes your GPG key and it encrypts each password that you provide for it and stores the encrypted version in the Git repository. Whenever someone looks at your repository, they will only be able to see the encrypted version, and the passwords can only be decrypted using your private GPG key. I'm also going to show you in this video how to set up a private repository on your own server. So I'm going to be doing this on Manjaro because it's a very popular distribution, and if you use Arch or Artix, then this will be a breeze for you. So first, you'll need to install Pass from whichever package manager your distribution uses. In my case, that'll be Pacman. I'm going to do this all on the command line. I'll run sudo pacman-s pass. And that'll install Pass. Now, if you haven't created a GPG key yet, you'll need to do that first. I don't have any GPG keys set up yet, so I'll start by creating a GPG key. I'll run GPG generate key, and GPG will prompt you for some information, your name, an email address, and you can confirm by pressing O and hitting enter. Then GPG will prompt you for a password, which will be used to secure your GPG private key. I'm going to specify an insecure password. Say, yes, I'm okay with an insecure password. So now my GPG key has been created. So now I should be able to create my first password. I'm going to run pass, insert, and then an identifier that indicates what this password is for. That failed, and the reason it failed is because I have not initialized my password store yet. To do that, you'll need to run pass init and then specify your GPG key. So I'll run pass init, and I'll take the fingerprint from my GPG key here, which, by the way, you can also get from running GPG list keys. You run pass init and then paste in that GPG key fingerprint. So now my password store has been initialized with this GPG key. So let me try inserting a password again. Using the pass insert command, it'll prompt you to specify your password. And that'll store that into my password store. My password store is a directory in my home directory called .password-store. And I can see my password has been stored there in a GPG encrypted file. If I look at the contents of that file, it'll be, you know, something that I wouldn't be able to read. To get the contents of your password, you'd run pass and then specify the name of the password. And then pass will prompt you for your GPG private key password, which will unlock your private key so that your password can be decrypted from your password store. This is the password that you set up when you ran the GPG generate key command. So there's the contents of my password. Okay, now let's set up Git integration. So to do that, we'll run pass git init. And that will create a .git directory in your password store and make that password store a Git repository. So I could come into the password store directory and run git commands. And you can see there's my, pass automatically creates commits whenever you insert a new password or change a password or delete a password. Now let's go over to the server and set up a Git remote. Okay, I'm on my server now. The first thing I'm going to need to do is create a directory where I can store all of these Git repositories that will correspond to my password stores. I'm going to create a new directory under SRV, and I'll call it Git. We'll also need to create a user on the server that you'll log in from the client as when you're synchronizing your repository. I'm going to call the user Git. User add Git, and I'll specify his home directory to be the Git directory that I just created. Now let's change the permissions on that Git directory to be owned by the Git user. And you can now see that my Git directory is owned by the Git user. Now let's change to being the Git user, su git, and then we'll initialize our repository. So we'll cd into the Git directory. This is my Git user's home directory, and I'll run git init bare password store.git. Now I have a bare Git repository initialized on my server. Also, we'll need to set up an SSH daemon. So if you haven't done that, you'll need to install OpenSSH and make sure that the daemon is running. You'll also want to make sure that port 22, the SSH port, is open on your server. I've already set up my SSH daemon, and I've opened up port 22 on this server. Now let's go back to the client and see if we can push the repository. We're back on the client. Let's first add a remote to our password store Git repository. We'll do that by running pass git remote add origin, and we'll specify the user name git at the host name or IP address of your server. And then the path to the Git repository. Right, that created the remote, and it's called origin on our password store repository. Now we should be able to push our passwords up to the server. And on the initial push, you'll need to set the upstream to origin and specify the branch master. Now it'll prompt you for the Git user's password. So that'll be the password that you created when you set up the Git user. And in my case, I never set up a password for the user, so I'm going to go back to the server and do that. So I'm here on the server as the root user, and I'll run pass wd git. I'll type in a new password, confirm it, and now the Git user has a password. So let's go back to the client. All right, we're back on the client, and let's try running this push command again. It'll prompt for the user. I'll specify the password, and it successfully pushed. Now, if you want to avoid having to specify the password to the Git user every time you synchronize the repository, you can copy your SSH key to the authorized keys file on the server. To do that, you run ssh-copy-id, and then specify the I flag, and then the path to your client's SSH public key. And then specify the host. It'll ask again for the password. And in this case, I didn't specify that I wanted to use the Git user. So I'm going to hit Control C and get out of that and make sure I specify the Git user. Okay. So that'll copy my client's SSH public key over to the server. So now when I run git pass git push, I won't have to specify the password. Let's try that out with a new password. I'm going to insert a new password called my second password, and I'll specify a value for it. Now I'll run pass git push. And that synchronized my new changes up to the server. So one of the main purposes of a password manager is to allow you to share the passwords for your various online accounts with multiple devices. So now I'm going to show you how to set up the password store application on your mobile phone. I'm using an Android phone, and don't worry, no Google apps are required for this. All the apps I'm going to be using are available on the F-Droid store. So the apps that you're going to need are the password store app, and also the Open Keychain app. This should be all that's required to get you started. What I'm going to do first is set up a GPG key. I'm going to go to the Open Keychain app, and then up here where it says you don't have any keys yet, click here to create or import one. I'm going to tap that. Then I'm going to tap Create My Key. So the setup here is going to be similar to the way it is on a desktop client. You'll specify a name. I'm going to say Wesley's phone. Tap next. Then an email address. Then tap next. And then it'll ask you if you want to publish on the key servers. You probably don't want to do this. There are situations in which you would want to publish your public key on key servers, but I'm going to leave that unchecked for now. And I'll tap Create Key. So once that's done, I can see my Wesley's phone key has been created here. So to set up SSH authentication so that you can use an SSH key from your phone to connect to the Git server, you'll tap on this key that you created. Then you'll go over here to the hamburger menu and then tap Advanced. And then come over here to Subkeys. Once you're on Subkeys, you'll hit the Edit button here, and then the plus icon at the bottom. And you'll want to create an authentication key. I'm going to say no expiry, and then tap OK. All right, and it says here that a subkey will be created, and I'm going to hit Save. All right, that created an authentication key, which will allow me to authenticate with the Git server. So now I'll want to upload the SSH public key that I've created here on my phone to the Git server. There's a lot of ways you can do that. You can email it to yourself. You can extract the SSH key from your phone by going to the share page here on the app and then tapping share as SSH public key with, and you'll hit the share button. And then there are various options. I don't have a mail client installed, but you could email it to yourself. You can also make a copy and send it some other way to your device. I'm going to do that by copying to a file share, and I'm going to do that off screen, and I'll come back once I have the SSH key up on the server. So I'm back on the server, and I've put the SSH public key from my phone into the authorized keys file in the Git user directory. So if I'm currently in the SRV Git directory, and if I look at the .ssh authorized keys file, that second line there is the SSH key from my phone. So now let's go back to the mobile phone and set up the password manager app. So what you'll want to do is go to the password store app, and you'll probably be greeted with a screen like this. You'll tap Let's Go. And then since we're going to be cloning the repository that we've put up on the server, I'm going to choose Clone Remote Repo. So here you can see the configuration that I had from last time I set this up. You want to specify SSH :// the user git at, and then specify the hostname or IP address, and then finally specify the path to the Git repository on the server. Then you can specify the branch here, which is master. And under authentication mode, we're going to choose Open Keychain because we're going to use the SSH key that we generated in the Open Keychain app. So now I'll hit clone. Now it's going to ask me to choose an authentication key. I'll tap this one here, the one that we generated earlier in the video, and tap select. There, so now that downloaded the Git repository from the server onto the app. But if I tap on one of these passwords, you'll see a message at the bottom that says no encrypted data known with known secret key found in stream. So what's going on here? Is the key that we used to encrypt the data is the key that's on our client, on our desktop machine. But we don't have the private key on the phone to decrypt the secrets from the password store. So what we'll need to do is we'll need to reinitialize our password repository so that either the desktop private key or my mobile phone's private key, either of them should be able to decrypt the secrets from the password store. So let's go back to the desktop app and do that now. All right, so I've got the GPG public key from my phone onto the computer, and I've placed it in this ASC file here, this phone public key ASC. So first I'll need to import that ASC file into my GPG keyring. To do that, I'll run GPG import phone public key.asc. So that imported my phone's public key into my computer's keyring. So now when I run GPG list keys, I'll see both my key as well as my phone's key. Now, pass won't allow you to initialize the password store when the trust is set to unknown and needs to be set to unlimited. So before I can reinitialize the password with both of these keys, I'll need to change that. So I'll run GPG edit key and then specify the key thumbprint. And then I'll type in trust. And then I'll specify number 5, I trust ultimately. Yes. Now I'll quit. Now if I list my keys, I can see that the phone key has its trust set to ultimate. So now I can reinitialize my password store repository using both keys, which will encrypt every secret using both public keys, so either private key can decrypt them. To do that, I'll run pass init, specify first my computer's key as well as my phone's key. And that re-encrypted all of the passwords such that either private key can decrypt them. Now I'll resynchronize by pushing the changes up to my server. All right, and now I'll pull the changes onto my phone. All right, I'll go to the password store app. I'll pull down to resynchronize. Now I'll tap on a password, and it'll show me the password contents now. I hope this video has been helpful and informative. If you have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them in the comments section below, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.